Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got shit! Another good one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep in on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly, you'll shift in with Doug.
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Noi.
Oh my God.
And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Damn it. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
A rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding. When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left. That much, huh? Does Kenny know?
I don't know.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the motor inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
He's got a wife and son to look out for.
And they're safest in a big group. Going out on his own will get them all killed. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
Who knows what Larry's problem is?
Maybe that's just the way he is, but that guy needs to chill out. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
Knock me flat.
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys?
Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
I don't know, man!
Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help him.
Please!
Ben, shut up! My dad was Special Forces. I know what I'm doing!
Just see if you can get him out! After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care! Please!
Was he bitten?
Bitten? No, I swear!
Hurry, please, hurry! Lee, this trap has been altered. There's no release latch.
Oh no.
Shit. Walkers! It's now or never, Lee.
Please! Get me out of this!
Mark, get the boys back! Kenny, keep those walkers off of me!
Lee, do something!
No, no, no! Try the trap again! Anything, please!
Let's go! Let's go!
Free, it has to be!
Look up!
Shit! Is he?
He passed out.
If he's alive, grab him and let's go.
Behind you!
Travis!
Come on, come on, we gotta move! No! The gate's open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on! Come
on!
Oh
my god! What happened?
We're
what the hell? What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat,
okay?
Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know!
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking minute?
What? No, I don't! I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
I thought we could save his life. I'm the one that took his leg. That makes me responsible.
Well, that was a stupid thing to do.
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine. You guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know,
You like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
It doesn't matter who's in charge. Those people are here now. I guess we just have to decide what happens next.
No, Lee, it does matter. One person can't be in charge of everything. You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence, but sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall? You think this is easy for me? Everyone's starting to hate me because I'm the one that rations the food, but nobody else wants to. You know what? I'm not doing it tonight. You do it. There's today's food rations, but there's not enough for everyone. Good luck.
Dirty, but it's not gonna hold up forever, just like the rest of this place. Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure. What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there, having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. What is it between you two? Why do you have a personal grudge against Lee?
He knows why.
You've got to talk to Lily about getting along with Kenny.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together. We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that. We'd be fine without you.
Lily thinks we should throw these new people out.
Damn right. There's too many people hanging around here as it is.
Keep up on that fence.
Don't tell me what to do, Lee.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied. How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way. How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
I don't know either.
It's killing me.
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The man you saved is Mr. Parker, the band director at my school. We all came down from Stone Mountain for the playoffs when everything happened.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to normal in no time.
I sure hope so.
How you doing, Clementine? Everything all right?
Yeah. Is that man going to be okay?
I'm not sure.
I hope he will. I'm so hungry, Lee. I hope I get to eat soon.
That thing doesn't work anymore, does it?
No, not since it broke at the drugstore.
Just gonna hold on to it then?
Yeah, if that's okay. I need it.
It's okay, hon.
You said they'd find us.
I know, I did.
And until then...
Look, Clementine.
I'm not stupid, Lee. I know it's just pretend. But it makes me feel better.
Okay, you take good care of it then.
I will.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
I love apples. Thank you. Are there more?
No, honey. That was the last one.
Oh.
Enjoy it. You deserve it. You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
How you doing, Duck?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring.
Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope.
Oh, I know. It's a goat, right?
No.
Hey, Duck. How about a little food? Here.
Yeah! Oh man, I'm so hungry!
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
Lily has me handing out the food.
Ugh, that can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food, even though that guy can be a real dick sometimes. On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you, if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
What about you? You need food, too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
Thanks, Carly. Back in a bit. Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet.
I'm not sure that's the best idea.
You gave Glenn your blessing when he left. Just asking you respect my choice as well.
Yeah, but he was leaving to find his friends. Your family's right here.
Well, here isn't doing us any good. You should think about coming with us, you and Clem.
We need you here. We have a better chance of surviving as a group.
Our best chance of surviving is to get away from the mainland. My mind is made up.
We should talk about you and Kenny.
What about us?
The arguing. It's getting pretty out of hand. You know people notice that.
Look, I'm working my ass off to make sure we have a good setup here, and Kenny just doesn't appreciate that. All we need is food.
But there is no food. You know that better than anyone.
Well, we'll just have to find some.
Keep an eye out.
Fine.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now. I need space, Lee.
Want something to eat? If your camp got raided, probably means you haven't eaten in a while.
I am really hungry. Thanks.
I need to keep my strength up, too.
Not such an easy job, is it? It's okay. I know you're still watching out for me.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Lee.
Kenny, I know I ran out of food before.
Hey, it was a tough choice, but you took care of the kids. That's what a real man does. I'm serious about that offer to come with us. You've more than earned a ride on the RV with me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out! What happened to my food?
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah? Well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Kaja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed! You said he wasn't bitten.
What?
We asked you point blank, was he bitten, and you said no.
He wasn't!
Well, your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife!
What?! Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us. When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax! Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
Are you armed?
Yeah, for protection. Dead could be anywhere.
But I think you got the upper hand here.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit.
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
You've got a deal. We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator? Well, I'm here whenever you want to talk.
Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
Lily. Runs a pretty tight ship. Her and her dad are ex-military.
Yeah, she knows her shit, but she needs to know when to back off sometimes.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Well, the kid here's our newest arrival, but we're all looking forward to some food. We really need it.
Well, here's to helping each other out. Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for, well, as long as I can remember, but now it's getting...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always pumping this shit.
Bandits? Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it off yourself.
There's only two. Oh, no. There's
Yeah, and you know what? We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out. I hope they move on.
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Asshole.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on. Let's get to the dairy where it's safe. Here it is. St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
Ever have any accidents?
Nah. It's safer here than out there.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
Hold on, I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah, I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh my! Our prayers have been answered!
Maybe our whole group could come. For the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right. I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
Too bad it's broken.
I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. John's know we can pull our weight around here.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots. We gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
He wouldn't be such a pain in the ass if you weren't telling him we were talking behind his back all the time.
I'm sorry, all right? Well, maybe a good meal will chill him out a little bit. There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off. Disgusting. Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
Yeah, well, it's useless without gas. We might need food, but the St. John's need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down. That's all.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it. never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Would have been nice to get some of those rations. I get hungry too, you know.
Just try to focus on the task.
They knew what they were doing, teasing us with food and then giving us chores.
Having a good meal will be worth it.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on!
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here. What the?
Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole!
Jesus!
We had an agreement! Now you fuck!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out! No fuel! Of course!
Get closer! Shit! I see you! I don't think I can't see you! Did you really think you could fuck with us?
Come on! If we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah!
They're on the move.
Shit, that hurts.
You assholes deserve to die! I already got one of you! Trying to lure me out with us!
What happened?
Shit! It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move it.
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Where's our food, you asshole? Did you really think you could fuck with us?
Get out of here!
You lucky sons of bitches! Go ahead and run! We ain't going nowhere!
Lee! What's wrong?
There was a goddamn ambush out there!
Holy shit! Are you okay?
Bandits? Here? On our property?
Oh, my lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh, no, honey. Come on, Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veteran.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhand. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
It was just a fluke thing. You can't stop assuming there aren't bad people out there.
What the hell do you mean a fluke?
It could have happened anywhere. Could have happened to us in the motor inn.
Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope you kids like swings.
A swing! I love swings! Just like at my treehouse! Come on, Doc!
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Yeah!
Thanks.
Anytime. We're looking out for you.
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
Not sure, Clem. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You got lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
And we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
Don't worry. We're safe here now.
As long as the bad people don't get me too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. All right, Clem. That's enough for now.
Okay. Thanks for pushing me.
Of course. It's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck. Don't pop a gasket.
Hey.
Hey, Lee. Found anything interesting?
I'm just trying to make sure this place is secure. In case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
No, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
That's funny, considering you didn't seem too worried about Duck back at Herschel's farm.
That's in the past, Kenny. But lots happened since then.
Yeah, right.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry.
You're with me on this, right? Huh. Always the diplomat.
I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out. There's not enough room in the house for all of us. I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
How do you feel about leaving the motor inn?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
How do you put up with him?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad, and I love him.
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right. Let's just wait for dinner, and then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything, but gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah. It'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it? You see anybody?
Stay on your guard.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent. Camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently. Just water.
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff. Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Empty.
What'd you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on. I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily, right. You did say she was running things for you. Sounds like you picked a good leader.
Nothing. Yuck. I don't need that. Nothing but fumes. Shit.
Your guns down.
I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
Now maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down! You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball and into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her!
So what if I did? You stole her from me!
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Okay, fuck this shit.
Go on! Tell him, boy! Tell him what you got in mind for— Oh!
God damn it! It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message. Come on. That was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back! What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Dunno. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
They have different ideas about how we should run our group. If they don't find any common ground, this whole thing's gonna fall apart.
No, it's just tough times. Everyone's hungry and people get a little stir-crazy when their tummy's empty. And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
Hello. Glad I got to use her today. My girl here.
How do you run this place with just one cow?
Used to have more. They get hungry too. Or sick. Got your doctor friend here now, though.
You guys must trade for a lot of fuel to keep the generators running, right?
People get hungry, and a few loaves of bread fetch a high price. Y'all are luckier on this side of the deal now.
You guys are pretty out in the sticks here.
Hard to find.
You get many visitors?
Not anymore. Bandits, of course. Used to get these school kids on tours back before the dead time.
You really like that gun.
What's not to like? Exactly.
I'm gonna go wait for supper then.
It'll be a good one.
Hey, so what happened at the camp? Did you guys find any more of those guys that hurt Mark?
We found a woman in the woods. She was talking all crazy and had a crossbow. So Danny killed her.
Holy shit. Was she one of those bandits?
I don't know. I think she was trying to tell me something. But then he just went off.
I don't like this, Lee. I still say we should go back to the Motor Inn, where we at least know what to expect.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something.
But you told him to mind his own goddamn business, right? We are guests here. We don't need to be overstaying our welcome more than we already are.
The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
Do you get the feeling something's going on here?
What makes you say that? What exactly happened at the camp?
It's nothing. Don't worry about it. Paranoia just getting to me a little bit.
I know what you mean. These backwoods people always give me the creeps. If you ask me, we should just get our dinner and leave.
Come on now. We don't want to be rude.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay, go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
How do you like that cow, Clem?
She's pretty.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I don't know. I haven't thought about having kids in a long time.
Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead. Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like manure.
What's manure?
Duty.
Kids?
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he oughta.
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
Thanks.
Yep.
You found it too, huh?
Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff, and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem? You gotta think about that little girl, Lee. Look, that guy with Katya. What's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No! Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban?
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Just checking out the barn here. Never been to a dairy farm before.
Just don't roam around without me or Danny. The farm can be a dangerous place. You know, the bandits and all. Sorry about your friend. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Danny mentioned he needed something.
Did he say what?
Shit, I can't remember now. Sorry.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
Like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul. I still can't get that lock off the door.
You probably just need a screwdriver or something.
False alarm. I'm back.
Oh.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Just gonna borrow this for a second. Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Danny needs something again.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
There's gotta be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while. What about those generators?
Thank you.
Damn, this thing is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
I'm glad Andy knows how to fix this if something goes wrong. I'm clueless about this stuff. There you go.
Ow! Damn it! The thing is moving fast!
There, that should do it.
Fucking Danny, where'd he find this piece of shit? Oh, fucking thing threw a belt. Damn it, Tom. Ah, son of a fuck. Oh, this take forever.
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Didn't you hear the bell? Dinner time. You know, you're a strange guy, Lee. Well, anyway, we best get going. I'll fix this door later.
Oh, Brenda, you are an angel.
Oh, excuse the mess. We had to block the back door after a walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. I'll go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now, don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
This must be Terry. Some kind of lotion. Gauze pads. I could use a shave. Is that blood?
Something?
Aw, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee, what's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
You're eating human meat?
That's crazy.
What the hell?
You're scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
Go upstairs and look. You'll find a guy with both of his legs hacked off. This is a dairy, not a ranch. Think about it.
It's true.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Kenny, get your gun!
Kenny, no!
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the what? The fucking what?
Put your guns down! We're walking out of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
I'll kill you!
Another way out of here.
You sick fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit! I will knock the goddamn door down!
It was a person. They tried to make us eat a person.
But you didn't do it.
No.
The rest of us did, goddammit! If you hadn't dragged your feet...
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
You okay, Clementine? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Mm-mm.
Open up!
Lee, those psychos have my family, and we're stuck in a damn meat locker! We gotta get the fuck out of here!
This goddamn thumbsucker was the one who brought us here!
Will you all just shut the fuck up?
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walkers!
Dad, please!
Don't give up. We're gonna find a way out of here.
Can I help?
Sure, honey.
You keep your eyes open for exposed screws or loose panels. Anything we can pry away to open a passage out of here.
Okay.
Come on! Try yourself! Fucking cowards!
Dad!
They got Katja and Duck, Lee! Those fuckers have my family!
I know! We're gonna get out of here and find them.
There's more of us on the way!
Your dad's not making things any easier for us.
Open the fucking
Dad,
door!
Dad, stop!
God damn it!
They're not gonna open the door!
Come on, Larry. Do you really want to attract their attention?
Yeah, I want to attract their attention so I can fucking kill them!
Guess your new girlfriend wasn't all she was cracked up to be.
What the hell is your problem? You refused to give me my day's rations back at the motor lodge. And you went out of your way to be an asshole to me tonight. You must really hate me. But guess what? You're stuck with me. I plan to be around long after you're gone. And if you turn, I'll be the one to put the axe through your skull.
Dad!
Open up, goddammit!
I'm not your enemy, Larry.
I don't believe you. Don't forget, I know who you really are.
Dad, this isn't helping!
Inbred bastards! I'll break that damn door down!
Dad, you can't get... Easy! Breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit. Is he dead?
He's not dead. Somebody help me.
Fuck. If he's dead...
He's not dead.
What has to happen, Lee? Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am. But in a few minutes, we're gonna be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed-off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
We'll mourn him later, but right now we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He is not dead!
We can't kill him if he's not dead, Kenny.
You remember how hard it was for you to get that monster off of Katja? And Larry's twice his size. It's him or us.
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. But come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on, Lee. You can't be in the middle on this one. You gotta have my back this time.
God damn it, Lee. I need you! Please help me! Come on, Dad. Come on.
Get this
you
over.
Fucking monsters! Both of you!
I don't want to see!
I'm sorry, Lily.
No!
It's the only way.
Get off me! Don't do this! No! Let go of me! No! Please! No! No! Don't you fucking touch me!
Clementine. Clem. You okay?
Why, Lee? Lily said he wasn't dead.
He was dead, Clementine.
But what if he wasn't?
He was, I promise. I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else, something hopeful.
Like what?
How about your walkie-talkie? Those pretend talks with your mom and dad, don't those make you feel better?
Sometimes. We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it. You think maybe we were too hasty?
Only one important thing right now. getting the fuck out of here. We did what we had to.
Katja and Doc.
What about them?
You don't think they're St. John's?
No! They need Katja, remember? She's the whole reason they brought us here.
Sure. And Doc is valuable as a bargaining chip.
We've got to get to them.
What now?
You got any ideas?
The air conditioner. There might be a duck behind it.
Oh, God. What are they doing to Katja and Duck?
It's just you and me. Lily's in no condition to help us rescue your family.
Considering what just happened, she'd probably side with the St. John's against us.
I know it was necessary, but I just wish Clem didn't have to witness shit like this. I worry what it's gonna do to her. Lily, I'm sorry.
Don't talk to me, Lee. Don't fucking talk to me. Don't look at me either.
What do you want me to do? Never mind.
Get away.
I just need to...
I told you to get the fuck away!
There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
I don't know, Lee. Seems like a long shot.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use.
I've got a rock.
A rock won't help. But a coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin?
Uh-uh.
Get away.
If the duct behind the air conditioner is big enough, we might have found our way out of here.
Yeah?
But I need something to loosen the screws.
I got nothing.
Shit. Hang tight. Maybe I can scrounge something.
Why can't you just leave me alone?
I'm sorry, Lily. But if we're gonna get out of here, we need your help. And Larry's. I think I may have found a way out of here, but I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something...
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
In other words, my father's more useful to you dead than alive.
If he was alive and had the key to getting us out of here, do you think he'd keep it to himself?
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
You fucking vulture!
Huh. He still carried his wallet.
My mother's.
Don't worry. I'm not taking it. Here we go. Two quarters. And a dime. Just gotta remove these screws and get this unit off.
Huh?
You got it?
Yeah. One more should do it.
Well, here's our way out, Lee.
We don't know where it leads.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
I can find out.
I know you're brave enough.
I'm scared.
Remember the treehouse? You held out for days.
And I saved your life.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
God's sake, Lee. Didn't even get to say goodbye.
Get in here. I got an idea.
Stay here. Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
Slaughterhouse.
Dumbass is so caught up in his own rant that we could probably sneak right up on him. Just stick behind me in case anything goes down. When we get to the front, grab his gun.
Sounds good.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Stay close.
Finishing that damn dinner first, put it on the other plate at least.
Dad, what are you doing outside the barn?
Oh, shit!
Just guarding the place, like you said.
You keep sitting out in the rain like a damn deer. Mama says we can't keep that many folks alive and not expect trouble. Pick one to keep and kill the rest.
Can I pick which one to keep alive?
Not the kid. Enough meat on the tray.
Oh, I know, Mabel. This is my favorite.
Keep your eye on
too. When I let one think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
Lee, focus. Where's Danny? Tell me what's going on.
See him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Look again. He didn't go past us.
We'll take him out together.
How?
He doesn't know we're out. He's gotta walk past us. Now, you won't make me kill you!
Fuck you, Lee. You and Kenny murder my dad, but you leave this piece of shit alive? Fucking asshole.
Oh God, don't hurt him!
That's Katja!
Please, no!
Lily, please, keep her safe.
We were coming up to the house.
They attacked us!
I knew it. I told you we couldn't trust them.
Shit! How many of them are there?
Two left.
Where?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed him to us.
Shit! Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Duck and Katja in the house. And I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right. We're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
You've been hands and nose snooping around me!
go, Brenda!
Lee! Please, don't you take another step!
Brenda, come on now! You know you don't want to do this!
Just go away and leave us be!
His dairy turned into a slaughterhouse.
I'll kill her, Lee. Stay back. Don't do anything stupid.
Let her go, Brenda.
Please, listen to him.
I'll do it.
Please.
Kill you, Lee!
Please don't make this any worse!
Just stop!
You ain't shit!
It's over!
Fuck you! As soon as Dan and Mama get out here, you're all fucked!
They're both dead!
What did you do? What the fuck did you do?
Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee! Get back here and finish this, Lee! Get back here and fight me like a man, Lee!
Lee!
They're getting in!
Lee!
Let's go.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people? For food?
Well, I hope for Clem and Duck's sake they didn't see any... God, that they weren't exposed to... Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark. Do you want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document your thoughts on.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be. Hun, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
We fucked up. We fucked up real good.
You can't say that, man. The rest of us are alive, aren't we?
Yeah, I know. I've got your back. We made the right choice, but what the hell happens now?
Listen, that RV back at the motor inn is just about ready to roll. I want you to come with us. I mean it.
Okay. Yeah. Come on, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, are those bad people dead?
No. They're alive and suffering. They were very bad people. But if they die, it won't be because I killed them.
Okay.
Hey, Dad. What's that noise?
Sounds like a car.
Oh God, not more strangers.
Hello? Figures.
Oh, crap. Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
This food could save all of us.
Not all of us.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? Well, what if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
We have to take this, Clementine. We need it to survive.
Who says it's your decision to make?
Hey, we don't have time for this shit. Like it or not, we need this food. Now get over here and open the trunk, Lee.
More food in here. Great. Maybe we'll survive this after all. Duck, why don't you carry this?
Okay.
Supplies?
I'll take it.
Got a box of food here.
I'll carry it.
This hoodie looks to be about your size. Why don't you hold on to this? It might get cold.
It's not mine.
It's yours now.
Hey. There were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you? Oh, God. Lee, you're gonna wanna see this.
Oh, shit.
Baby, look at you. Look at you. Oh, you need a mama, sweetheart. We won't let them bandits get you, will we? No.
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it,
thinking you're safe. Sitting there acting like things are the way they used to be. The dead don't kill their own. It's the living you gotta be afraid of. The people I used to call friends. People who took... Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe. I promise.
Making is done, pal. Ain't nothing left. We gotta get the hell out of here. Lee, I need you to back me up on this.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave.
Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases left, but it's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
And we killed her dad.
He did kill her dad. Maybe people out there got things lined up better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Do people get mad when they're scared?
Sometimes, yeah, they do.
This is crazy! I'm the one keeping this group going!
We can sort this all out, all right? We can sort this out!
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!